Today, I'm headed on another snake call. Actually, no, I'm not. I am headed on a snake skin call. Is this the snake house?
Yeah.
They haven't seen a snake here. They just have some workers out here, and they've seen several snake skins. And I talked to them on the phone, and I was trying to explain to them that, yeah, I don't know what kind of skin, what kind of snake it is, but from my experience, it's usually a rat snake, which are good snakes to have around. But to some people, it doesn't matter what kind of snake it is. It's a snake. To them, a snake is a snake is a snake. And they don't want to always agree with my assessment of what I tell them over the phone. So they insisted that I come out and crawl under their house, which is what I'm going to do. Apparently.
Look,
what you want me to wear under there?
I'll be so. Oh God, I have on everything.
Jesus. These knee pads are snake proof. They can't bite through my knee pads.
I can bite everywhere else.
So she doesn't understand why I'm just wearing knee pads and not a snake proof bodysuit under her house. I guess a lot of people don't understand that. If you don't understand snakes. Let's see here. Luckily, I'm a little guy, so I can squirm and fit under these houses so easily. If I was a big guy, I might not want to do this kind of work. At least it's nice and cool under here. You gotta look at the good things in life. Nice and cool. That's the only good thing I see so far. Now, just coming in the entrance here, I don't see any snake skins yet. But I do see something that I really don't like. And that is those ducks right there. The problem with those ducks is I gotta crawl under them. Let's go. What is that noise? I just found my first sign of a snake, and it's right here. Don't mind the roaches. In between those two roaches is snake skin, all broken up and crumbled. So that's some pretty old skin. Here's a little bit more of it here. More skin. More skin. And this is from a rat snake. This particular skin is from a rat snake. So rat snakes are normally what we see under houses like this. I've removed venomous snakes from crawl spaces like this before, but normally it's gonna be a rat snake. Okay, now, right here to my left, I just noticed a problem. This duct going to the heating and air unit has a big gap in it, big enough for a snake to possibly crawl into. So you can have a snake end up in the heating and cooling ducts of your AC here. So I don't have anything with me to seal this up, so I'm gonna take a photo of this for her so she can see that this needs to be dealt with. There we go. It looks like there's some snake skin right over there. Is that snake skin? Let me get closer so I can see. Yep. More snake skin right here. So this too is from a rat snake. And this is kind of an older skin. It's really brittle. And I think that snake is probably long gone by now. Doesn't mean there's not more here though. All right, now I found something really interesting. Right on the top of this ductwork here, running down this ductwork, is this. What is that? That is snake poop. Snake poop. Now this is old dried up snake poop, so it's been here for a while. But if you look at this snake poop right here, that white chalky looking stuff is basically their urine. Their urine doesn't just come out in a liquid. It comes out kind of like pure white toothpaste, uric acid. And as it hardens, it actually hardens almost like concrete if you're trying to scrape it out of a snake cage. But over time, when it's there for a long time, it becomes chalky and gets all broken up and disintegrated like that one is. So that is some old snake poop. I just found something. I just found a little dead snake. And this snake has been here for a long time. And like the skins that we've already seen, this is a rat snake, a little baby juvenile rat snake that died a long time ago. I have a feeling if I tell this lady that I found a dead snake under her house, no matter how little or how decomposed it is, she ain't gonna let me leave without the dead snake. She ain't gonna sleep in this house with a dead snake under her house. So I guess I'm gonna have to collect this thing and take it with me. All right, it's in my pocket. So one dead snake in my pocket, still crawling around. I thought I remembered saying something about it being cool under here. It doesn't feel as cool now. I'm hot. All right, I just found some more interesting evidence that there would be snakes here. And that is right up here. If you can see up there, let me try to get in close so you can see this. Right there are a few mouse droppings. So there's mice here, and there's more mouse droppings right here. If you can see that piece of tape there, their mouse droppings kind of stuck onto that tape. I guess they're falling down as the mice travel across this beam here, down into here, and some of the mouse droppings. Hey, look, there's mouse dropping. Oh, there's a snake skin, okay? So right here, we have a few mouse droppings down through here. There's a snake skin right here, and that's a small snake skin. The other skins we found were pretty big. And this skin is a pretty small skin, and it's old. This is not fresh because it's just peeling up here. But that skin is definitely from a rat snake. And you can see there's a skin here and there's mouse droppings here. So I wonder why the snake was right here. That's because there's critters for him to eat right here, I think. I mean, everywhere I look here, I'm seeing little things that tell me that snakes were here at some point. Here's another skin here. I mean, so right there is another little piece of skin. That's a bigger piece. And right there is a little tiny piece. Now this piece, so this looks more fresh to me. It's a lighter color, and it's not as fragile and brittle. It doesn't break up in my hand. And this piece, I just saw, is from a bigger snake, but this is older. And this kind of, this piece is more brittle and kind of breaks up in my hand. So there's just so many places here that snakes can. Look what we got here. Look what we got here. I think we found what we're looking for. Right here is a little rat snake. And it's a fat little rat snake. He's got something in his belly. And look, he's just sitting there under this block, hoping that I wouldn't see him. Well, buddy, I'm sorry I found you. And the lady and the man that lives here, they do not want to share their home with you, okay? As good as you are to have under somebody's house, you're going to have to go with me. So come on, fella. Oh, hang on. It's okay. It's all right. I'm not going to hurt you. Yeah, look at you, buddy. Aren't you pretty? Look at that belly. That's a full belly right there, too. Well, this is pretty cool. We just found a little rat snake. And didn't think I would today. I mean, even though we're finding skins, there's so many places to hide under here. This is perfect. So, I say that because I hate going on a snake call and not finding a snake, which happens a lot. So I'm thrilled right now to have found this little rat snake. And it's time to go. Let's take him out of here and look at him. So I made it back to the crawl space entrance here, and I'm gonna sit here for a minute and just kind of cool off, because it is a little cooler under here than it is outside right now, and I want to have a look at this snake. So as I said, this is a eastern rat snake. This is a juvenile, maybe born last year. When these guys are hatched, they're not quite this big. But as an adult, hey Phil, I'm getting something off of you. As an adult, they get to be much bigger. This snake can easily get 6 feet, sometimes over 7 feet long. And because they get so big, they scare a lot of people. Now, I understand if you have a snake in your house, in your attic, under your house, most people don't care what kind of snake it is. They just don't want to have a snake there. I get that. But just hear me out. This snake is not going to cause any damage to your house, whether it's inside your house. It may damage you from you hurting yourself, but if it's under your house or in your attic, this snake is not going to actually cause any damage, okay? But seeing a snake skin or seeing a snake under your house, basically what that means is, it means you have suitable habitat for snakes. This is a great hiding place for snakes, one, but it's also a great hunting ground for snakes if you have mice. And every house I go under, they say, well, I don't have mice. Well, unless you're hanging out under your house at 3 o'clock in the morning, you're probably never gonna see them. So that's why we look for mouse droppings. And so you need to get the mouse problem under control, which this guy will help you with, okay? But people are just terrified of snakes and they don't want this thing under their house. And I understand. I wouldn't mind having it under my house, but I understand why most people don't want that, because most people really don't know a lot about snakes. You know, I say this all the time. I've never met a person who knew a lot of accurate information about snakes and didn't like them. If you hate snakes, that just means what you know about them is false. That's it. People argue with me on that, but that's the truth. You don't have to love them, but once you really understand a snake, you will appreciate the value of a snake, even a venomous snake. Yeah, even a venomous snake. So I'm going to take the snake out of here. We're going to find somewhere to turn him loose, away from houses where he won't get back in here. And we're going to suggest that she has that vent, that duct sealed up, so a critter doesn't get up in there. And maybe she needs to do something about her mouse problem out here, because once you get rid of the food source, you shouldn't have snakes. Now, sometimes what happens with rat snakes and all snakes is when they get ready to shed their skin, they secrete like a lubricant underneath that layer of skin, and that helps their old skin to slide off easier. Sorry, fella. I talk with my hands a lot, and snakes don't seem to like that, okay? But when that milky substance is under their skin, it's also covering their eyes, so they can't see well, which means they can't look out for predators. So coming to a place like this, while they're shedding their skin, which may take a few days, you know, for that to clear up and go away so they can shed their skin, this is a good place for them to hide out. So that's why we often see snake skins in places like this, because snakes are just hiding out here, shedding their skin, and then leaving the crawl space to go somewhere else. That's usually what's happening. A lot of people also think that a snake under their crawl space, it's made its home there, and that's not the case. These snakes may come and go, and you may have many snakes coming and going, but this snake is not taking up residence and just living here under your house. They come in, they find a meal or two, they may shed their skin, then they usually just leave and go somewhere else. Snake repellent does not repel snakes. That's why we're not selling any to this lady. A lot of companies sell snake repellent because they just want you to shut up and go away, okay? And make a little bit of money off of you, you know, while they're doing that. Mothballs do not repel snakes. People see a snake, they put out mothballs, they don't see a snake for a while, they think the mothballs are doing the job. Then when the snake returns, they're like, oh, well, I guess it's time to reapply the mothballs. Mothballs don't repel snakes. Mothballs have a substance in them called naphthalene, which has been shown to cause cancer in people. If you can smell mothballs, you're breathing in some of those chemicals. And it's also illegal to put out mothballs on the ground around your house. Lime does not burn their bellies. It does not repel snakes. Sulfur stinks. Snakes don't care. They'll go across it and go find a food source. Get rid of the habitat. Get rid of food sources. That's what'll control your snake problem, not spending money on snake repellents that are just going to waste your money. If you're going to do that, just give me the money, okay? Give me the money for this advice. You're still giving your money away, but you're getting something that actually works. All right, little fella, you're pretty cute. You calmed down a little bit, so I'm going to put you back in the pillowcase. People say, why are you putting it in a pillowcase and tying it up? Well, these guys actually kind of feel secure in there. It's a nice closed-in place. It's dark. They feel hidden, just like he was under that block over there. So he actually feels safer once he's inside the pillowcase. Put you right back in here. Go hide. Make sure he's not in that part I want to tie up. Don't want to be tying a snake in a knot. There we go. Shut my foot in the door. Now, I have to go find a place nearby away from houses to turn the snake loose. See you later.
Okay,
bye-bye. Yes, ma'am. We got a two dead snakes, I don't know, two or three snake skins. We saw some snake poop, did not take it, and one live snake. So when these people called me originally and I was telling them information about, you know, whether I thought it was a rat snake and that it'd be a good idea to leave a rat snake and not have me come out and go into their house, They wanted me to come out and go into their house. So we did that. But you know, after I told them what I found and that it was a rat snake, the gentleman, he was like, maybe we should just leave it there. And she's like, no, we're not leaving it there. You take it with you. So this house, I drove by here the other day and I was looking and I said, you know what? If there was ever a house that could use a pretty good rat snake, I think this is it. Now I know what you're thinking. And why would you do that? Why would you go turn this rat snake loose at someone's house. If you know anything about snakes, you'll probably agree this house could use a good rat snake. See that? That's the house. That's it. Nobody lives in this house. And it is an abandoned house. And if I was a rat snake, this is where I'd want to be. Because this rat snake has already told me today that he does want to be in a house. He wants his own house. I'm just trying to watch where I'm stepping. This is a snaky house. All right, I was walking through the grass, watching where I step, like I always do. And I just saw something right here that would make me have a very bad day if I stepped on it. And that thing that I'm talking about is poison ivy. Right there. You know, I can spot poison ivy from about 6 miles away because of all the havoc that stuff has wreaked. I mean, you would think, knowing that I was going to be an outdoors kind of person, God would have made me immune to poison ivy. But that is not the case. Man, that stuff tears me up. All right, little snake. This can be your home if you so choose. And you've got a lot of growing to do, and you can do it all right here in these spacious accommodations. Well, I'm not going in the house. I'm going to stay outside here. And I think what I'm going to do, I'm going to let the snake decide where he wants to go from here. I'm going to release him on the porch. And if he wants to go off into the yard, which is right there, or if he wants to go into the house, he can do so via the open door. So we're going to turn him loose. Well, I feel pretty good about that. Not only did I get to go remove a snake from someone who was terrified of it, but I got to release that snake in a place to where it'll be able to hide from predators. It will find plenty of food, and it will most likely not run into a person again. You notice I'm wearing a different shirt. That's because I released the snake yesterday. And now once again, I'm back. I'm here to do a temporary fix on that duct. And as I'm working, all of a sudden, this creature just shows up and scares me half to death. I didn't know what it was. And then I realize it's a dog. Then the dog disappears. Okay, that's kind of creepy. I'm under here. And the entrance to the crawl space, the door just slammed shut. I bet it's that stupid dog. That dog's gonna lock me under here.